Today I'll be talking about the 2018 CVPR paper, Learning to See in the Dark. Can you see what's in this image? Barely, right? Neither do I. Let's see the result output by their algorithm. Wow, it's phenomenal! The brightness of the image is increased significantly. Let's take a closer look. It's even remarkable that the algorithm also recovers the original color of the books. As you can see in the left image, the light is so dim that it seems impossible to tell which color it is. My name is Steve. I'm a professional data scientist and a cargo conditions master. In this video, you'll learn how the paper achieves this extraordinary result. I'll give you an overview of the paper, talk about the limitation of existing algorithms, explain the neural network architecture in detail, and demonstrate the result compared with other state-of-the-art techniques. The paper proposed a new application of existing deep learning model for processing dark and noisy images. The main contribution is presenting a concise image processing pipeline capable of removing the noise and naturally enhancing the luminance of extreme short exposure image. At the same time, it also automatically adjusts the color bias, just like what I've shown you previously. Let's take a look at some previous study of denoising algorithms. The two most advanced non-data-driven methods are BN3D and Bursting algorithm. Unfortunately, these algorithms suffer from severe noise and color distortion, as pointed out by this paper. Although studies regarding using deep learning to tackle this problem shows promising results, such as denoising autoencoder and multilayer perceptron, they were actually evaluated on synthetic data. In fact, another CVPR paper states that the traditional algorithm BN3D outperforms the more recent deep learning models on real photographs. So these two algorithms will be the baseline this paper comparing with. There are a couple of low-light image enhancement techniques, from the traditional gamma correction and histogram equalization to a recently published Retinex model. These methods, while generally produce acceptable results, failed on noisy images, and they sometimes adjust the color bias incorrectly. The paper points out another issue faced by deep learning models in denoising and luminance enhancement. That is, there is no high-quality public dataset for such purpose. The available ones are either spatially misaligned or lack of ground truth. So they created their own dataset by taking photos with their cameras and tripods under different exposure time to make sure that the input and the ground truth images are perfectly aligned. Okay, now that we understand what challenge they're trying to conquer, let's dive into the model architecture and pipeline. The model they use is a family of fully convolutional network called UNET, originally used for biomedical object segmentation. It learns to segment image in an end-to-end setting, which means that it takes raw image as input, and the output will be of our desired format. By comparing its pipeline with the other existing methods, you'll notice how neat it is. For traditional pipelines, you need to go through a lot of individual self-contained modules, each of which contains parameters requiring manual tuning. On the other hand, in the proposed pipeline below, there is only one module, which is the fully convolutional network. The amplification ratio here is just for adjustable brightness of the output image. So, what's the magic behind UNET? Well, it can be split into two parts, the downsampling part and the upsampling part. The key component is the lateral connection between these two parts. This allows the network to backpropagate richer spatial information to the former layers. In addition, it enables the low resolution but semantically high feature maps to combine with the higher resolution but semantically low ones. Therefore, the resulting feature maps in the upsampling part contain more fruitful semantics. This can probably explain why UNET can transform the color correctly. Let's take a look at some result comparison with the traditional pipeline. The left image is the input, while the middle and the right one is produced by the traditional pipeline and the presenting method respectively. Although the traditional one successfully makes it possible for humans to perceive what's in the image, it does not handle the noise and color bias effectively. By contrast, the presented pipeline not only removes the noise, but also perfectly corrects the color bias. As a result, the right image seems perceptually better than the middle one. They also conduct a perceptual experiment on 10 different people by presenting the images from two different subsets of data. The X300 subset is deemed more challenging than the X100 one, as they are captured within short exposure time, which means that they are much darker. The number on this table represents the percentage of images that these 10 subjects consider UNET's result to be perceptually better. According to the table, the performance of the baseline and proposed algorithm are similar on the easiest subset, while the proposed pipeline outperforms the traditional methods significantly on a more difficult subset. This shows that the presented pipeline is very suitable for processing extreme low light and noisy images. What's more amazing about this is its ability to generalize on photos captured by different cameras. You might expect that the trained model only fits on specific cameras used for creating a training set. In fact, they can be applied to images taken by different equipment. This shows a comparison between the result of traditional pipeline and the proposed one by feeding the image taken by iPhone 6S. Clearly, the image on the right is less noisy and brighter. If such technology can be adopted on various devices, I wouldn't be surprised if it is ubiquitous in the near future. The main limitation of this pipeline is the inference time. Although it takes less than 1 second for processing an image, it's still not fast enough for real-time processing. Future work might focus on decreasing the model size for faster prediction. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this paper review. If you have any question or comment, please leave it below. If you like this video, please hit like or subscribe. See you next time!